Well, welcome to day five of the World University Games athletics program here in the Stadio San Paolo in Napoli. The men's 3,000 meters steeplechase. Mokopane back to see if he can complete that trip to the top of the podium. Ali Messaoudi of Algeria was on the medal podium back in Taipei as well. No Algerian in this final though. Well, there he is. Mokopane of South Africa goes to the Northwest University in Potchefstroom. Silver medal last time out. He also was in the 1500 meters in Asia 2 years ago, but not quite so successful, although he did reach the final. He's not the fastest man in this race either on PBs. That goes to the, well, the inexperienced Moroccan, Mounam Sassoui. He was, albeit 24. So away we go then. It's just under 7.5 laps of the circuit. The reason why it's not exactly 7.5 is because, as you will see, they are going round this first time. They go round the water jump, which is on the inside of the track. Most of the modern water jumps are on the inside. You do still get the occasional circuit track which has the water jump on the outside. But, straight away going into the lead is Araui Sayaguchi of Japan. Goes to the Tokai University. And personal best this year in winning the national championships in Fukuoka in June. Fastest into the final here today, but four more men have better personal best than he does, including Sassoui, Smeaton, Degagne and Stevens. We'll come to them as the race progresses. So you can see the Moroccan there very much in contention. 8:51.36 he ran in the heat. This is his first international championship, the man who goes to university in Fez. 24 years old, down to 8:22 this season. They hit the water jump for the first time then. Just seven more to do. And it is still Sakaguchi who leads at the moment from the Moroccan Sassoui. And not surprisingly, Mokopane from South Africa not too far behind. Mokopane, who went to the African Championships in 2016 and got to the final there too. Ashley Smith is the other South African, just 22 years old, in his first international championships. Just on his shoulder of his more experienced teammate there in third and fourth, respectively, the two South Africans. The Australian that you can see, Matthew Clark. There's another one, Max Stevens as well, both 24. Stevens won the national title back in April in Sydney. In 8:39, you've got a personal best that's another 10 seconds faster than that, but the Japanese here is pushing them around. Still leading there in single file mostly, except for that front four. Title won 2 years ago in 8:35.88. His title in the past has gone to the likes of Martin Grau of Germany and Igazia Safulin of Russia. Shenzhen champion saw a change of nationality where the Portuguese Alberto Casemiro Paulo took it in China. And at the moment, it looks like a Japanese is taking on the rest of the field here in Italy. Still the Ryoi Sagakushi, 22 years old, goes to university in Harasuka-shi. World Junior Championship experience as well in the past at 1500 meters. And he's going along a nice clip at the moment. Four laps to go, 70 second lap. And the Japanese at the moment still looking the most comfortable. Ashley Smith in second place at the moment. And the Moroccan also there as well, Sasui. And who goes to the Sidi Mohammed Ben Abdullah University. Is looking very, very good at the moment. Very different style to the compact, rather busy-looking pace of the Japanese in front of him. It's a much more languid and leisurely stride from the Moroccan right behind him that looks very good at conserving the energy as you get into this latter part of the race. They're beginning to get split up now. The front five now beginning to pull away. The two South Africans still very much there, and joining the party is Jean-Simon Degagne, the Canadian. Smeaton also there by the looks of it. Smeaton, though, just beginning to drop off there with his long hair. And it's still Sakaguchi. It'll be two laps to go when they come round to the line for the next time. And Sakaguchi has been unable to break the men behind him and has just dropped the pace just a little bit. Five men in touch. Degagne looking like he's dropping off. And Mokopane there is at the back of that front five. So then the scorer down at the finish line changes the marker to just two laps to go, and it's still the same man that's been in front all the way through the race so far, Ryohei Sakaguchi. But he's just slowed it up as they come to the first hurdle of the next lap. Sasui still looking very threatening. He goes in front, in fact, now. Ashley Smith still looking good. Sasui, though, running well. Now the Canadian beginning to suffer. These two now beginning to get away. Mokopane needs to pull his socks up. Back in fourth place at the moment. And the Japanese, who looked so strong just a lap ago, has suddenly blown it. Sakaguchi now dropping off the back. Had one of the better personal bests of the runners here, so it's a little bit surprising that he's struggling so much. Sasui then leading at the moment. They will hit the bell this time. It's down to gold and silver now. South Africa in second and third. Sasui, who was fastest in the heat and is showing his pedigree here in the final. He goes for the long haul. 500 meters from the end, he broke. Now he's still in front and he's pushing it all the time. South Africa at the moment, still second and third. It might well be just the minor medals for them. But Sasui of Morocco is pushing hard. He's keeping his legs high, pumping his arms. A little look behind him there, just to see what was happening. And now Smith is beginning to struggle. You can see his head just going there. He took that hurdle very heavily indeed. Sasui now coming to the water jump for the very last time. He'll have 150 meters to go when he lands on the other side. Sasui is going to take this, I think. No one's going to take him here. Sasui is going to do it. Mokopane finally gets it together. And the man who was silver medalist last time out looks like he's going to take it again here. Can he get there? Sasui is beginning to tread water. Needs to go. Oh, my goodness me. He's going to get him on the line. Sasui gets it. Wow. Well, he was just playing with them, apparently. What a finish! Well, if the South African had that inside him, left on the last 80 metres, why did he not push it earlier? Well, Mokopane there, that is bewildering. Silver medalist 2 years ago, by less than a second, he's done it again. Less than a second. He lost out to Zielinski 2 years ago of Poland, and now he's lost out to the Moroccan Mounam Sassoui. And the student from Fez has completed his first international championships in stunning fashion. Well, again, we've seen a race tonight where the athlete that went off hard in the front just served to be a pacemaker for the rest. This time it was Sakaguchi of Japan. He looked very comfortable until the last two laps, and then just suddenly everything just disappeared from his legs. Sasui, though, a very, very good run. And the man from the land of Said Owita, himself, who has been a star in the past of the Universiad, comes across the line, but my word, he's looking up at the screen to see whether or not I think he can just celebrate and take it easier. Mokopane absolutely sprinted down that final straight and nearly got him. Look at this, Mokopane's not even in shot. He's just almost jogging here. You think he's got it. He thinks he's got it. He thinks he's so far in front from looking at the board and the TV, and then suddenly he realised Mokopane's coming. So confirmation then of that splendid victory in the 3,000 metre steeplechase for Mounam Sassoui ahead of Ranzo Alfred Mokopane, who misses out on gold by a second for the second Universiad in a row. Third place going to Ashley Smith, the bronze medal winning run in 8 minutes 33.6. The 110 metre hurdles. Men are back out again. The final of the 110 metre hurdles. So. And we're away, and it's a very sharp start by Izumiya once again. The Japanese is away. Will he be able to last until the end this time? Inside him, though, Constantino has gone past him. Constantino is going to take this to the line, and he takes it ahead of Bolossien. The two heavy hitters through the rounds have proved themselves in the final, but it's another gold medal for Brazil. Gabriel Constantino in 13.23 seconds. That's a high-quality time. And the gold medal for Gabriel Constantino in a time rounded down to 13.22 ahead of William Bolossien of France in 13.3. And Shunsuke Izumiya of Japan just gets the bronze medal in 13.49 by 1/100th of a second from the local boy Perini. Next up on the track is the women's 5,000 metre final. Jessica Judd looked very good indeed, the World University Games bronze medalist. She and Hannah Miller are the only ones from that final who are back in this one. Hannah Miller, the New Zealander, 21 years old now. She was only 19 when she went to Taipei. Jess Judd was 22, so a relatively experience in comparison. So then they set off. 12 and a half laps of this Stadio San Paolo track. And you can see the Japanese has gone to the front. Wada. You know, Wada is just 19 years old, the diminutive Japanese who goes to the Melio University in Nagoya-shi. Asian Junior Championship cross-country short course champion. That's a mouthful in 2018. Well, we are three quarters of the way through the 5,000 metres for the women, and the pace is around about 15:15. It has been ever since the beginning of the race. They went through 1,000 led by Wada. Takamatsu, her, the Japanese teammate, took over for the second 2,000 before Wang went almost immediately back in front. Jessica Judd kind of went in front as they came through to register 9:36.52 for 3,000 metres, but she didn't want to be in front, that's for sure. She's there now, and she's being accompanied by the Australian Caitlin Adams. They are really all in with their chance at the moment. The Ethiopian, though, Akash Kinetibeb, just 18 years old, who was in the 10,000 metres and was seventh in that on the opening night, is now just beginning to lose touch with them. Ethiopia still celebrating their bronze medal from last night in the steeplechase, but it doesn't look like they're going to get another medal here. Jessica Judd still leading at the moment. She encourages Caitlin Adams to come through and take it over. Wang is in third place at the moment, and it looks as though Katarzyna Jankowska, the Pole, is coming through, the woman from the Higher School of Higher Education and Tourism from Białystok, more noted for its football team, Jagiellonia Białystok, in the Polish Ekstraklasa. But she's not quite kicking on at the moment. But there she is, the tall Pole, outside of the much more diminutive Japanese Wang. Also still very much in it is Julia van Vethoven, the Dutch woman, in the orange at the back with the blue bottoms. Now, 15:50 might not sound very quick on the Diamond League circuit, but a lot of these women, that's very close to what their personal bests are. So not the likes of Jess Judd. She's done a 15:31 PB. She's the fastest in the field, and of course she has been to plenty of big championships. She has run the fastest of any woman in this field this year. There are others who have perhaps got a better personal best, but I think Jess Judd is due a big upgrade in what she's capable of doing. And after that bronze medal last time out, she knows that she is in a wonderful place here to kick on and upgrade to at least silver, but mainly she wants the gold. There's an American in this as well, Noel Alan Palmer, just 20. Two Japanese are still in there. The other Japanese, Tonomi Musumbi Takamatsu, just 19 years old. Has been to the World Junior Championships, though, where she was seventh in the 5,000 metres there. She came in to this race the fastest in the field on personal best, but only ninth fastest this year. So how will that pan out? And she must have heard me, because she's now gone to the front. Just cuts across Jed Judd, and she has to chop back and recalibrate herself. She's in second place at the moment, though. The Canadian also going well is Nicole Hutchinson, a 22-year-old from the Villanova University in Pennsylvania, United States. A woman who also went to the World Juniors 3 years ago. Didn't get out of the heats, though, at the 1,500 metres. Has stepped up to the 5,000 here. Jess Judd just on the edge there. She's thinking about going, but they are, this is not the real crunch yet. They have not really released the afterburners. When they come round next time, it will be the bell. Just a tricky back mark here that they have to make their way around. Jess Judd then taking up the running. 400, 500 metres to go. Hutchinson still there. There are some dropping off the back now. It's Hutach, including Janowska, the Pole. Expected her maybe to do a little bit more, but she's losing out. Van Vethoven, the Dutch woman, is still there, though. The bell goes in and Jess Judd strikes for home. Yuna Wada is there as well, just the 19-year-old, the Asian junior champion, short course winner at cross country. Fourth in the World Juniors last year, but Jess Judd is gone. She's kicking away. The gap has grown from 4 to 5 to 6 metres. Hutchinson is going off behind her for Canada. And it's the Dutch woman, Veldhoven, who has the bronze medal position at the moment. 200 metres to go. Great Britain looking towards their first gold medal of the track and field events. Jess Judd looks strong, very strong indeed. It was only bronze for Jessica Judd 2 years ago in Chinese Taipei, in the much cooler environment here in Napoli. She's going to strike home for gold in the 5,000 metres. A first global gold medal for Jessica Judd. She knows it's coming, arms out. Gold for Great Britain. Hutchison takes the silver for Canada. And Veldhoven takes the bronze for the Netherlands. 15:45.83. They speed it up just ever so slightly in that last kilometre. But really, the pace didn't matter. That was all about winning. Perfect tactics from Jessica Judd. She upgrades two places from Taipei. And you can see that she's strewn on the track. It's not always possible to celebrate glory, although if you're Italian, you can celebrate whatever happens. That's Maria Chiara Cascavia. Hug for the winner. That was class, though, from Jessica Judd. Well, there's some fans in front of us saying that they love Chiara, but there'll be a lot of British fans who have just as much amore for Jessica Judd. Well, somebody has managed to crack out a union flag for her to celebrate with, but it's nice. All the girls down there are giving her a hug. Well, it was a slow pace, if all honesty. But once things kicked off in the final 1,000 metres, Jessica Judd has gradually wound it up. And then over the last 500 metres, she was the one that moved to the front. As they hit the bell and went round the first bend, she opened up a 5-metre lead. And that lead just continued to grow. She already knows she's got it, I think, here. She looks up at the TV screen, but she knows there's no one near her. The joy comes. And soon the gold will be hanging around her neck. First gold medal for Great Britain in Naples. But that was a great run by Hutchison behind her as well. Just 22 years old. She has a much slower personal best than Jessica Judd. But she came through there to beat a few women who have gone faster than her in their careers. Jessica Judd, who runs for Loughborough University, well-known sports academy in the United Kingdom. And confirmation of Great Britain's first gold medal. Jessica Judd winning the 5,000 in 15:45.82. Nicole Hutchison takes the silver medal.